who they are. Yeah. Most people are so busy dating other people they never dated themselves.
You understand? Hey guys, welcome to Redefined Gospel YouTube channel where we are thriving in Christ. This channel seeks to link the Word of God to the contemporary times and ultimately ensure that we are thriving in Christ. So if you're new here, please consider subscribing. Hit on the bell next to the subscribe button. Once you subscribe, a bell will appear. Hit on that bell so that you get post notifications each time. Sema hi.
Hi.
Yes, undo camera woman wangu. Sema jina yako.
My name is Steve Karaoke Njoroge.
Yes, he has been taking photos and videos of me. Afuambia subscribe.
And don't forget to like and subscribe.
Yes, and share. So, man, share.
And share.
So you may be here wondering about the title, you know, dating yourself, and you may be asking yourself, Anne, are you not contradicting yourself? Last week you tell us on how to pray for our future spouse, and by the way, thank you very much for the love you showed that particular video. In case you have not watched it yet, I'm going to put it down in the description box so that you can get to watch it. So you may be thinking, you taught us, you know, how this is how to pray for your future spouse, these are the 30 ways, you made a devotional and all that. And here you are telling us to date ourselves. But this is first and foremost scriptural. In the book of, and I'm going to insert that picture here, and it should just work on my scripture memorization right away. The word of the Lord says that love your neighbor as you love yourself. So the same magnitude you love yourself is the same way you will love your neighbor. So if you love yourself this small, then this is how small you're going to love your neighbor. So that is where it stems from. But my inspiration is drawn from Bishop T.D. Jakes and Stephen Furtick. There's a team, they had an interview. Stephen Furtick was the one interviewing T.D. Jakes. And in case you don't know them, I'm going to put the link to their YouTube channels. They are actually pastors. One for Elevation Church, and then the other church is called the Potter's House. And I really admire these people. I wish I could be like half the people they are, by the way. So Stephen Furtick was interviewing Bishop T.D. Jakes. And as he was interviewing Bishop T.D. Jakes, there's a statement that Bishop T.D. Jakes said, and that got me thinking a lot. I watched this like in April, so it's like 2 months ago, but that thing has lingered in my mind for the longest time. And after thinking about it and researching about it, I came about with 10, are they 10? Yes, 10 ways to date yourself. 10 ways you can date yourself, or 10 tips on dating yourself, or, you know, just 10 ways of dating yourself. So first and foremost, watch that clip where he talks about it. Just a snippet of it. I'll put the full interview down below. He was talking about his new book. It's called SOA, and it's an amazing book for people who want to enter into entrepreneurship and business. And in that particular book, there's a way he just got the statement of dating yourself into the interview. So you guys have a listen or have a watch, then we'll go straight right into the 10 tips of dating yourself. Karibuni sana.
What if I'm not clear about what I started with? Because I've heard you do this thing before too. Okay, the advantage I have interviewing you is I have a library of things that you've said. I don't think there's been a sermon.
I don't remember, by the way.
Yeah, so I have
I'm scared to death of the upper hand.
But you do this thing, all right. I saw him do this thing at a preacher's conference once. And he said, I won't imitate your voice.
Go ahead.
He has this really intense mode. There's a wide open Bishop Jakes, and then there's a very intense, it's many gears, but it's equal intensity, and it's terrifying. But it was a pretty big moment, and you say, "There's nothing that I have that you don't have. I have one mouth. You have one mouth. I have two ears. You have two ears." And you know how descriptive he is. He went all the way to the toenails. And I'm just being honest, Bishop, respectfully, I was thinking, that's not true. You have this mind and this ability and this voice, even as a preacher who admires you so much, there's a part of me that goes, I know the point is that God has given each of us a calling, but I think a lot of us, when we hear about the parable of the talents, we don't know, well, do I have one? Do I have two? Do I have five? I don't want to get out there and do something stupid that I wasn't meant to do, but I don't want to stop short.
You're really hitting on something. First thing, I am in touch with myself in a way that a lot of people are not. I know me. I dated me.
Cool.
Yeah. It's funny, but it's true. I've dated me. I know me. You know, when you date somebody, you explore them to see who they are.
Yeah.
Most people are so busy dating other people, they never dated themselves.
You understand? So, yeah, that's Bishop T.D. Jakes. You all should know him and just go and see his sermons. He's so real, by the very, very real pastors and ministers of the Word of God. Learn about yourself. When you are dating someone, you get to know that person better. And people used, I have some friends of mine who are making a joke about when we were in high school. I don't know if it used to happen to you when you were in high school. I'd really love to know in the comment section. In high school, we usually, Safaricom, the mobile service provider in Kenya, I think and beyond, but let me say in Kenya, safe to say that. So there was this SMS that we used to buy, the 20 SMS. So you buy 5 bob, for 5 shillings, you get 20 SMSs, for 10, you get 200. And we used to buy that so that you can be able to chat on our phones with, you know, other people from other high schools that we have made maybe friends within our neighborhood, of people we met during functions or funkies in high school. So the questions that people we used to ask in high school, like, hi, how are you? What have you eaten? I've eaten this. And you? Okay, what's your favorite color? What is your water? So we were joking with my friends just a few weeks ago and saying that those conversations are so fun. We were just laughing at ourselves and saying, Amy, right now, if someone is just asking me what my favorite color is, I just need serious questions like, where do you see yourself in 5 years and all those things. But as I'm thinking about those conversations we used to have in high school, those conversations were just meant to maybe know someone better. Maybe to some extent it was to pass time, but more specifically just to know someone better. So when you're asking your favorite color, probably that person will bring you a blue suit because your favorite color is blue. But it's the same when people are dating. You want to know what the other person likes, what they don't like, so that you do the things that this person likes and you don't end up doing the things that that person is. So basically, learn something new about yourself. I have a friend who was very intentional about it. I don't know if she stopped. Janet, did you stop? This is the time she used to tell me, hey, today I've discovered something new about myself. The following day, she was so excited about it. And at first, okay, sorry to say, at first I was thinking, oh, that's a bit weird. Like, how do you do that? But I have now discovered it is important to know yourself. For me, I have discovered so many things about myself. And at the same time, I have called myself out on things that I'm doing wrong, things that I'm not doing in the proper way. So it's an amazing way to love on yourself. It's an amazing way to date yourself. Discover each day something new about yourself. It's just an amazing experience. So discover something new about yourself each time. Yeah. So that's the first way to date yourself. Those days when you feel like, I don't have this, but affirming yourself just gives you a way, just gives you so much hope. It just gives you that energy that you can actually do with this. So just wake up one morning and just go in front of the mirror, affirm your day. Just declare your day is blessed. Declare things over your life. Just declare and affirm yourself. That's another way to just date yourself, affirming yourself. Just affirm yourself, you know, get into that mirror and just speak wonderful things about yourself. Second way to dating yourself, give yourself quality time. So there are 5 languages of love, and I was trying to see if I can be able to remember from the top of my head, but clearly my head is doing a lot of disservice to me, but I'm going to put them somewhere. But there are 5 languages of love, and one of them is quality time. And it is really important to give yourself quality time. quality time just to have your me time, you know, a very regular me time, just you and yourself, and you just, you know, soaking in your own company and enjoying your own company, just having a quality me time. One of that way you can take yourself out on a date. And give me, I've never done. Okay, I think I did once, but that time I think I was stress eating after, you know, I got a disappointment and said, let me get into the restaurant and eat. But very soon, and probably I'll document it and bring and put it on this channel, but I'm going to take myself out. But simply just spend quality time with yourself. You don't necessarily have to go to a restaurant or a movie, or okay, if you don't enjoy a movie, then you don't just do it because people usually go. But something that you really enjoy doing, just go and take yourself out. It is an amazing way to love on yourself. It is an amazing way to date yourself. You can also just, if you enjoy books, just sit down somewhere with a cup of coffee or juice and just read a book. Switch off your phone and read a book and just soak in your own company. You know, just enjoy that, your own company. So give yourself quality time, because most of the times we are out there giving, and the cup and the body, or the cup, let me just say the cup that is always, you know, filling other people becomes empty at some time, and it is just necessary for you to step back and refuel. Once you have refueled, you can just come and give people, you know, you give yourself to people. So it is really advisable, and it's a great tip actually to spend quality time so that you can, it's a way of dating yourself. Oh God, a sentence construction today. Gift yourself once in a while. When it's your birthday, are you the person who's like, oh, you guys, what are you giving me for my birthday? But there was like, even my status is just posting, you know, tech equipment and telling people on my WhatsApp, hey, you guys, I need this equipment, I need this and I need this. By the way, my birthday is next week. I'm shooting this on a Friday. I'm really hoping this video will be up on Sunday. On Sunday, hopefully, because hey, I've been just posting on Monday, but my days are usually on Sunday, 6 p.m. So that's the coming 27th of June is my birthday, and I wouldn't mind a tech equipment, maybe a camera there, a ring light there, a tripod over there, a lens over there. I wouldn't mind. But I found myself most time thinking, what are people getting me for my birthday? Or what will happen on my birthday? Who will surprise me on my birthday? And all those things. But even on your big days, gift yourself. Like this coming birthday, I'm planning to gift myself. I don't know what. It may not be like a very big thing, but just buy something for myself and thank God first and foremost for giving me the years that He has given me. And then also just to appreciate myself and just buy something for myself. So just gift yourself. If it's your graduation, just sit down and think, what shall I get myself for my graduation? It's really important, because I believe that sometimes we over expect from people, and it's good to manage your expectations, but managing your expectations does not mean no gifts and everything. Gift yourself, you know, so that even as you gift yourself, the same value you attach to yourself is the value people will give you, by the way. So gift yourself. Get away. Okay, not you can get a getaway and, you know, get away and go to like the Mara or something of that sort. But get away from the noise and just stay in solitude. It looks like having quality time, but you know, when you're having quality time, you probably go to a restaurant and there's a lot of noise. You probably go to the movie and meet a friend, and you know, maybe the noise will still be there. But this point is majorly, get away. Switch off your phone, switch off your phone, keep it aside and just learn a skill, or just stay alone and just reflect, meditate about how maybe probably your past year has been, if it's your birthday. Okay, I'm really talking about birthday because, you know, the birthday is coming very soon. But just get away and just be in that place of solitude and just enjoying yourself, enjoying the company, but you have gotten away from the noise. Because let me tell you, sometimes it's very difficult to love on yourself when so much noise is coming your way. You'll go on Instagram and maybe you're struggling with certain thing and you see someone doing really well, and that gets into your head, and maybe you may say, oh, that these things don't usually get to my head, blah blah blah. But in your subconscious, these things actually get into your head and you end up feeling miserable because things didn't go your way. And then you're seeing this person, oh God, they went to Dubai, they did this. It is important to just move away and learn to be independent and learn not to be dependent on other people's company, other people's opinions, and just be there and just talk with the spirit and sink in your own company. I hope that point is home. Get away. You can also get away. Respect yourself. Respect yourself. It is important. It's another way of dating yourself. Just respecting yourself. When you are dating someone else, you respect the other person. So respect yourself and create the non-negotiables for yourself. The same way when you are, when, for example, you meet someone and that person tells you, these are my boundaries, please don't cross these boundaries. You know, let's just respect each other. These are the lanes. These are as far as you can go. And because this is your significant other, then you respect their decision and you say, I'm going to respect you. The same way when you're dating yourself, respect yourself and have non-negotiables. Set boundaries and standards for yourself and know that I am valuable. Attach value to yourself. What is your value addition? Like, this is my value. This is who I am. I am a child of God. And a child of God does not do this. And I'm not going to allow people to disrespect me. And I remember I did an IGTV video about you give people permission to treat you the way they treat you. And I'm going to link down my IG. And if you're not following me on Instagram, kindly follow me on Instagram, jerogeand254. On Instagram, and the link to my social media pages is usually on the description box. So you can go right there and click and follow me on Instagram. So respect yourself. That's another way of dating. Learn and take up a new skill. Invest in your own personal development. That's another way to date yourself. Like, for example, even in the content creation space, it may interest you to learn how to do your editing better, how to film better. I have to confess, when I was starting up, my first editing, I did it like for how long? Like, I think I took like 5 hours to edit. And I was like, wow, this is what I'll be subjecting myself every week to. And then with time, I just learned how to cut the places that I've maybe moved or done something funny and just learned to cut. So I was just cutting my videos. I can't say I was editing my videos. Until now, I was like on YouTube watching other content creators. Some take even 6 hours, 7 hours, 8 hours. Not because they don't have the skill, but because they are more keen to detail and they are more keen to just bringing a great final product. And so if I wouldn't have gone ahead and invested in my own personal development by watching other people's videos, how they film, how they enhance their lighting. By the way, I'll show you the light that I'm using today. Like, kuna light mbaya nje, aki have digressed. But let me just say, this like very low lighting outside, and you know, I was to film yesterday. Quick story. I was to film yesterday, and then what happened? Oh, my phone wasn't like when I English charge. Like, I was trying to charge my phone and it was just getting to 2%, it goes to 0%. I don't know why. And there was amazing natural light yesterday, I'm telling you. By today, it's so dark, like so dull. But I got a hack from my YouTube video, and I'm going to show you the light I'm using. Hey, you've been shocked. So guys, just a quick commercial break. This is the light that I'm talking about. This light has just saved me big time, because if you can see the clouds right now, it's a bit dark. Maybe you can't be able to tell. But it's a bit dark. But this car light just is a hack. Got it from Nakuru, someone just bought, my dad just bought it, and all of us were like, how are you buying this? Kumbi, it was to help me in filming. So yeah, that's the end of the short commercial break. Buy this lamp for 50 shillings. Anyway, but that has just come with me being intentional about investing in my own personal development. So invest in your own personal development. And it's a way to show that you love yourself and just trying to be more skillful, trying to be more excellent in your work. It's just a way to show that you love yourself. So learn and take up a new skill. Invest in your personal development. Celebrate yourself. You see those small wins that you get? You know, you get to complete your education, you get to upload a video, because I can't just explain the feeling you get once you click publish on a video, once you have filmed it, edited it, uploaded it, waiting for it to process, and then you click that publish. It's a win. And trust you me, if you're waiting for people to come on and celebrate you, sometimes you may wait, sometimes you may get disappointed. So when something new, something good happens in your life, celebrate yourself the same way you will celebrate your significant other in their milestones, in what they have been able to accomplish. Celebrate yourself. Celebrate yourself. So that's a way to date yourself. That's a way to love on yourself. If you need to take yourself out on vacation, if there's money, if you need to buy yourself something good because you have been able to reach that milestone, do that. Celebrate yourself. That's another way. Finally, encourage yourself. When you have another significant other again, you will encourage these people when they are down. They will encourage you. Any, you will encourage each other. The same way, date yourself and encourage yourself. Sometimes we look to other people for encouragement. So you may go and tell someone, hey, I'm feeling bad, or I'm in this place. And that person may laugh it out. But it happened to me yesterday, but I won't go into details. I was feeling so down yesterday, so down. And then I just expressed myself in a certain way, and then somebody just laughed. And I was like, okay, wow. So I'm not getting any encouragement here. And later actually this moment, I've just thought about it, and I was like, sometimes we're looking to people for encouragement, and maybe we just need to encourage ourselves and to allow the Holy Spirit to comfort us and encourage ourselves. So encourage yourself. Yeah, simply just encourage yourself and just give yourself the psych and the zeal. Yeah, simply just encourage yourself and give yourself the what is it called? Just give yourself psych, give yourself, you know, that oomph, and just to carry on, just encourage yourself. And that's, yeah, so that will be it. That is simply it for this week's video. I hope you enjoyed this video. So if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. It supports this channel. And kindly, if you are at this point and you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe. Hit on that red button, and then a bell will appear. Hit on the bell so that you get post notifications each time I upload. Thank you to everyone who has subscribed. Thank you very much to everyone who usually comments. God bless you. Thank you very much. It means a lot. So see you next week. And until next week, it's a bye-bye from me. And remember, always, as always, as always, God loves you a lot. So even as you're going to seek love from other people and feeling unloved and feeling like you're not appreciated enough, know that God loves you and He appreciates you so much. So
hi.
Ngoja hapa kuna late. Bye. Kuja tu. Sema hi.
Hi.
Yes, undo camera woman wangu. Sema jina yako.
My name is Steve Karaoke Njoroge.
Yes, he has been taking photos and videos of me. Afu wambia subscribe.
And don't forget to like and subscribe.
Yes, and share. Sema and share.
And share.
Sema bye.
Bye.
Sema see you next week.
See you next week.
Bye. See you next week. Remember that God loves you a lot. Yes. Won't be subscribe, subscribe.
Subscribe, subscribe.
So much. So as always, remember that God loves you a lot. Until next time, bye-bye.